Well, while the NHL trade deadline is not until April 12th, this year, things could be looking a little different, including teams making deals a decent amount ahead of time before this trade deadline. Joining me today to break down everything coming up to this date is Eric Bay. Eric, thanks for taking this time.
Yeah, if you're a Canadian team, your deadline is almost within a week here, just with that two-week quarantine.
Yeah, that 14 days is going to throw teams for a loop. They're going to be, you know, making acquisitions potentially for players and not seeing those benefits for at least 2 weeks there. And it's really going to change things up. Eric, another thing that will create problems for teams this year is that flat cap that was set at the beginning of the year. You know, teams like the Tampa Bay Lightning, the Edmonton Oilers, Washington Capitals, these teams have $0 to spend at this upcoming trade deadline. Just it'll make things interesting here, especially, you know, with those four teams per division making the playoffs there. Eric, you know, ahead of this deadline, let's break down some of the upcoming potential free agents who we could see finding new homes on April 12th or possibly before here. Eric, just kick things off here. Who do you think is a potential trade candidate coming up?
I like Kyle Palmieri just because, you know, obviously he's having a down year this season, only 5 goals so far, but the previous 5 seasons, you're basically guaranteed to get 25 goals out of him. So he's a proven sniper and has done it on some not very good New Jersey Devils teams. And I think a team that could use a guy with his skill set is the Boston Bruins. There's lots of chatter that they are looking for a top six forward. I think Kyle Palmieri is a guy who could slot in there very nicely and maybe come alive with some better players, some better weapons around him, and maybe some second power play unit time. Also, it seems like every other weekend it's the Bruins and Devils for the early game on Sportsnet on Saturdays. So they've seen a lot of advanced scouting on him, so I think he'd be a good fit there.
And he does add that gritty side of a game, especially for a guy, like you said, who can get you 25 to 30 goals per year. He does play that sort of Bruins style of hockey, and his cap hit is only around that $4 million range. So it is something that the Boston Bruins could afford there, especially, you know, we've seen injuries to the Bruins as of late, Tuukka Rask, a couple others that have really hurt the team. They're going to be looking to add some players like Palmieri just to boost them back up in the standings. That's a good pick there, Eric. You know, I'm going to be sticking with the forwards here. Eric Staal, we've heard his name bouncing around a lot, and we've heard a lot of different names coming from the Buffalo Sabres organization. As, you know, let's face it, they are having a down year, to say the least. Eric Staal, he's getting paid $3.25 million this season, but he's only produced 10 points in 36 games. I think potentially on a different team, he could have that revitalization, and he's also a playoff player. Remember, he's won a Stanley Cup, you know, leading the team in points back when Carolina beat the Edmonton Oilers in 06 there. He's got that experience. He's 6'4". I think he would fit great back on Carolina. They could use that help up the middle, and they are a young team. The only player on the Carolina Hurricanes currently who's over the age of 30, Eric Staal's brother, Jordan. So I think he would be a great fit there, Eric.
Yeah, you say 10 points is a down year, but he's performing like a superstar compared to the rest of the Buffalo Sabres. So for me, that definitely makes him an attractive option. And you mentioned that cap hit too, a lot lower than other guys like Taylor Hall, who's getting paid $8 million for the season. But I do like that idea of him moving to Carolina, especially with a young team, kind of need that veteran presence, brings that cup experience, and has been around the league a bunch too. But for another guy with some experience, I think who could help some young team or at least a young position group, I like Matthias Ekholm, and I like him going to the Philadelphia Flyers. Philadelphia right now, obviously in a dogfight in that East Division, currently sitting just outside the playoff spot, looking in and looking up at a team like Boston. And I think they could use some help defensively on the back end, especially when you do look at a veteran presence, because let's face it, they have a pretty young blue line. I mean, Ivan Provorov hasn't become a star, but he's still super young. They have guys like Travis Sanheim, Robert Hägg, Philip Myers, and those last three guys are mentioned. Robert Hägg has the best plus minus of any of them at even zero. So I think a guy like Ekholm can come in. He's a two-way force, very good defensively. I think he could help them show them the ropes and shore up that defense, especially when your goalie of the future, Carter Hart, hasn't been performing like he did last season.
And Ekholm, another benefit to him is he isn't a free agent come this offseason, so they will have him, you know, longer than just a playoff run coming up. eBay, Quickly, a final one from myself, Jamie Oleksiak, another big D-man who can play that two-way type of game. In Dallas's playoff run last year, he was lights out, only 9 points, but he brings that physical element. I mean, 6'7", almost 260 pounds. A lot of teams could benefit from having him. I think the Florida Panthers, you know, to keep up what the momentum that they've had and the success they've had this year, could totally use a guy like Jamie Oleksiak. Eric, things should be interesting as we get closer to this April 12th trade deadline. Thank you very much for taking this time and joining me.